गुड इवनिंग सर।
वेरी वेरी गुड इवनिंग बेटा। बताओ
गुड इवनिंग सर।
गुड इवनिंग।
गुड इवनिंग सर।
गुड इवनिंग बेटा। एवरीबडी गुड इवनिंग। ओनली 8 स्टूडेंट्स आ देर ना।
यस सर।
सो विल स्टार्ट द सेशन।
यस सर। यस सर।
या सो लेट मी सिलेक्ट। वी आर what we have discussed in our last lecture
so chemical reactions that
okay.
chemical reactions and equations
it 10th class. Okay. Okay. So, should we start the session? Okay, so we have discussed till here. Okay, in last lecture we have discussed about chemical reaction and their types. Okay, so now one by one we will discuss about each type of chemical reaction. Okay, so I think we have already understood about the word equation, hai na?
Yes, sir.
And the symbol of element and their valences now we are going to discuss today. wait a second. So am I audible to everybody?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let me check if somebody is there in waiting room or what. No, nobody is there. Okay. So symbols of element and their valences. Okay. So how to write the chemical equation we have discussed earlier. Okay. What we have discussed? Reactant are written on left hand side. Okay. Suppose this is the arrow. Arrow represents the direction of reaction. Okay, so in this is the left hand side. So in left hand side we are going to write all the reactants, and on arrow side, which is pointed toward the product, so we have to write product on this side, means right hand side. Okay. And we have already discussed about if two or more than two reactants are present, we have to separate them by using positive sign. Even same for the product also. Okay, if two or more than two products are formed, then we have to separate them by positive sign. Okay, if there any catalysts are being used, so we have to mention here. If heat is going to release, we have to write heat in this side. If it is going to be absorbed, we have to write on reactant side. Okay, so this or the point that we have discussed. If reactants are present in solid, liquid, or gases form, we have to discuss reactant as well as product, their physical state also. If we are using allotropic form of some element, we have to write the allotropic form also. Okay, so that we have discussed in our earlier class. So today we are going to discuss about the symbol of element and their valences. Now, what is valency? Anybody have any idea about valency?
Sir, combining capacity of an atom.
Yes, it is nothing but the combining capacity.
The number of electrons which are needed to be fulfilled in the outermost shell of an atom.
Sir, present in outermost shell.
Okay, no, not present. On that basis, we are determining the valency. Okay, if we will discuss about the nitrogen, you know, nitrogen have its atomic number 7 and its electronic configuration is 2 and 5. That means it required 3 electrons to complete its octet. So its valency is 3. But sometimes what happens, nitrogen may loses all the 5 electrons to show positive 5 valency. Means it will show positive valency, 5 valency also. So nitrogen have variable valency. It may show 3 as well as 5. It depends on what type of element is going to combine nitrogen. Okay. So valency is, you know, there are again two types of valency. One is fixed and another is variable. So nitrogen shows variable valency of 3 as well as 5. Okay. So we can say nitrogen have capacity to combine with 3 other element or 5 other element. Means we have to decide valency on the basis of their combining capacity only. Okay. Not on the basis of number of electrons present in their outermost shell only. Okay. So by which we can determine the valency, okay? By which we can determine the valency, how many electrons are present in their outermost shell, okay? That only helps to determine the valency of an atom or element, okay? So I'm going to write the valency's definition. So the combining capacity of an element is called as valency, and it is determined by number of electron present in valence shell of an atom. Okay, is called as valency. Okay, so again it is very important. Okay, and valency decide what type of product is going to form. Okay. So the symbol is the chemical code for the element. See, if you know, when element were discovered at that old time, at that time there are some symbols are being used. Okay, like few symbols are they are represent, like, you know, this, or maybe some symbols, some element they represent by this type of symbol, some represents by like this. Okay, so there are various symbols that were being used on previous time, okay, old time, to represent different element. But when number of different, you know, discovered in a large number, then to describe and to remember such symbol of the element was not, you know, possible. That's why they started naming the element. Like they named first element as hydrogen. Okay, then they name second element as helium. Then they named as third element as lithium. Okay, so, you know, to represent, you know, the element, by their name in periodic table in a short form is again not possible. That's why they used first letter or first letter along with second letter. Okay, so then hydrogen is represents as H. Then helium, if we will represent is it by H, then the both will symbol will be the same. That's why they taken second element as a small form. Okay, so helium is represents by He. Then lithium is represented by Li, likewise. Okay, so element, they have started representation on the basis of their initial letters, maybe first or first along with second. Okay, then each element has one or two letter atomic symbol, which is abbreviation from its name. Okay, so hydrogen is represented by H, so we can say H is abbreviation for hydrogen, He is abbreviation for helium, and Li is the abbreviation for lithium likewise. Valency, see definition of valency is written over here. Valency is the combining capacity of an element. So the combining capacity of element is called as its valency, and it can be considered as the number of electrons lost or gained or shared by the atom. Okay, it is nothing but the combining capacity of an element. It combines with another atom to form the molecule. Okay, so the combining capacity of element, which can be determined by the number of electrons present in their outermost shell. So I'm going to write over here, valency is determined by number of electron present in valence shell of an atom. Okay, so these are the very important one that you have to write, or you can take a screenshot also. Okay, then we have next point, writing chemical equation. So till here, you have any doubt? If you have, you can ask me the question now, or we will move further. Any doubt, anybody?
What is the valency of gold, sir? What is the valency of gold, G-O-L-D?
Gold. Okay. Gold is, you know, it again has a variable valency. Gold has its atomic number is 79. Its formula is Au. Okay. And its atomic number is 79. So it again contain variable valency. It do not have the fixed valency. Okay. Generally it combines with one chlorine to form AuCl, gold chloride. Okay, it may form, you know, if we'll react with sulfide, so we'll form AuSO4, so we'll source two valency. So its valency is not fixed, it shows variable valency. This variable valency is on the basis of number of electrons they are going to lose from their outermost shell. Okay,
sir, got it.
So you have to remember, it is Au is a symbol of gold and its atomic number is 79. Next, any more doubt? No? Okay, we'll move further now. So writing chemical equation. See, in previous lecture, we have already discussed about word equation and chemical equation. Okay, so like, we do not have to discuss on more because we have already been discussed everything. If you know representation of the chemical reaction in the term of symbol and chemical formula of the reactant and product is known as chemical equation. We have discussed in our last lecture, is it or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we have discussed about the word equation also as well as the chemical equation also. So see, it is Zn. Zn is the symbol to represent the zinc. Let me check once if somebody is there in waiting room or what. Yes, one is there. Two is there. Two are there. Now they are in. Okay. So I'm going to, you know, zoom in so that you will understand. Okay, now it's clear. See, here we have zinc. Yeah. And zinc is present in a solid form. So see here, S is written over here. Okay. For solid, the symbol, the small s inside the bracket, we have to mention. Okay. Here we are using H2SO4 is sulfuric acid. So we are not, you know, using the pure sulfuric acid. We are using a dilute form. And we are diluting this sulfuric acid by adding water. That means we can say sulfuric acid in water. That's why it is written over here, H2SO4 aqueous. Aqueous means watery. Okay. So dilute H2SO4 we are using. That's why we have written DIL for the dilute and AQ for the solution in water, aqueous solution. Okay. See, this arrow represents the direction of reaction. Okay. Means this is the left hand side, and inside we are representing the reactant. And this arrow shows the direction of reaction, means reactant to product. Reactant to product. So this pointed on side is nothing but shows the direction of reaction from reactant to product side. So what will form? The sulfate group will react with zinc to form zinc sulfide. It is again in water. That's why we have written over here aqueous. And hydrogen gas is released during the reaction. That's why this vertical arrow is shown over here, directed toward the upside. Means it is volatile in nature and will mixed in air. Okay. So this is nothing but the representation of chemical reaction. If we will use, you know, liquid form, so we had to write L inside the bracket, small L. If we are using the gaseous, see, hydrogen is released in the form of gas. So we can write hydrogen in bracket G means gaseous form and will released. Okay. So this is nothing but the representation of gaseous form. Okay. So we are using small g inside the bracket. If aqueous solution is used, then we have to write AQ form. Okay. If, you know, gas is produced, so we have to represent it by the vertical arrow directed upside. If precipitate is formed, precipitate will get settled down. That's why we have to write this symbol. Okay. If PPT is formed. Okay, so these are the symbols that we will use while writing the chemical reaction or chemical equation. Understood everybody, or any doubt you have?
No doubt, sir.
Understood, sir, no doubt.
Okay. Now, we have to discuss about the balancing chemical reaction. Okay, so see, there are many steps are given over here. I will share you the notes. I will explain you with the help of one, you know, chemical reaction so that you will understand properly. Okay. So we will use another technique, okay, to balance the chemical reaction. Okay. Till here, any doubt, any question if you have?
No question, sir.
No question, sir.
Okay. So let me check. Let me have one example so that you will understand easily.
Is there no sign for plasma, right?
See, plasma is, you know, the state possible only very, very, very high temperature. So to, you know, to make the plasma available for any chemical reaction is very difficult. That's why we are not using plasma. Okay, because to maintain such temperature, okay, and if that temperature, if chemical reaction will proceed, the, you know, explosion may be formed. Okay, that's why we are not using plasma, because plasma required a very, very high temperature and it is not possible to maintain such temperature. It will require more energy. Okay, that's why plasma is not being used. Even you will not, you know, hear this particular state of the matter till your study. Okay, you will only listen and study about that plasma state at your higher standard. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So now we are going to balance the chemical reaction now. So I'm just moving you little away from this. Okay, here we will understand balancing chemical reaction. Very important, huh? Balancing chemical reaction. Write down the heading, and you have to, you know, note all these things that we are going to use. So take ready your notebook as well as your pen.
Okay, sir, please continue.
Okay, so first, you know, example we are using, it is SO2. It is sulfur dioxide when reacts with hydrogen sulfide. It is H2S. It gives sulfur and water. Okay, so this is the, you know, chemical reaction that we had to balance. So it is not balanced now. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to separate and count all the, you know, atoms from reactant side and product side. So for that we have to, you know, divide this part into the two equal part into tabular form. Like I am going to draw table over here. Okay, so half part is for reactant and another half part is for product. Okay, here I am taking first element, sulfur. So sulfur in reactant side, see, we have two reactant. So in first reactant we have one sulfur, and in second reactant again we have one sulfur. So we have to add 1 + 1 equals to total 2 sulfur we have in reactant side, but in product side we have only one sulfur. So we have to write, and only one product we have in water do not have sulfur, so we have to write only one over here. Okay, then next atom I am going to use hydrogen. Okay, so in first reactant we do not have hydrogen, so leave it, but in second we have 2 hydrogen. Okay, so total number of hydrogen in reactant side are 2. Okay, but in product side we have 2 hydrogen. Okay, first, in first product we do not have any hydrogen, but in second we have 2. So we have to write here 2. Instead of this sulfur we have to write 1. One only, because we have one sulfur here. Hydrogen we have total 2. Now we have to take oxygen. Okay, so oxygen in product side we have here, reactant side here we have 2, and here is no oxygen is required for that reactant. So total number of oxygen 2. Here we do not have any oxygen, but here we have 1. So here we had to write only 1 oxygen. See, we will balance sulfur later on. Okay, see, in reactant side, so we have to balance hydrogen and sulfur, oxygen first. See, hydrogen are already balanced. Here we have, 2 hydrogen, and in product side again we have 2 hydrogen. But if we'll see oxygen, oxygen we have in reactant side 2, but in product side we have only 1. So what we have to do, we cannot, you know, write here any, you know, number, so that, see, H2O is water and H2O2 is hydrogen peroxide. So if we'll multiply over here, then the product will get changed. That's why we can't, you know, write here. But how? We can multiply with the coefficient here. So we have to multiply by two coefficient here. Okay. So I am going to write the next, you know, balancing part here. So it is SO2 plus H2S equals to sulfur plus twice H2O. So what we have done, here we have multiplied by 2. So here we have to again multiply by 2. So see, 1 into 2 will be 2 now. Okay, will be 2 now. See, we have balanced the oxygen, but number of hydrogen will also got increased. Is it or not? So in hydrogen also we have to multiply by 2. See, we have causes the, you know, on oxygen, but effect is also carried out with hydrogen also. So total number of hydrogen have become now 4. Okay, see, oxygen is balanced here, reactant side we have 2, product side we have 2, but now hydrogen in product side we have 4 and in reactant side we have only 2. So here we have to again multiply by 2. So in reactant side where hydrogen present, here, so here again we have to multiply by 2. So we are going to write the next reaction for that. It is step 1. Now step 2, what we have done, SO2 plus, here we are multiplying, 2H2S equals to sulfur plus twice H2. Okay. So here we have multiplied by 2. So now total number of hydrogen are in reactant side are 4. See, again, we have causes to balance the effect, balance the hydrogen, but effect is caused over sulfur also. Now sulfur we have in reactant side 2 now here. Where is sulfur? Here. So here we have to multiply by 2. So 2 into 1 is 2 and 1 will become 3. So I am going to write over here 3. But in product side we have only one sulfur. So hum kya karenge? We have to multiply sulfur by 3 also. Okay. So what we will get? 3 sulfur on product side. So here we have to multiply by 3. So it was the second one. Now third equation will become SO2 plus twice H2S equals to, say we are multiplying here by 3 coefficients, so 3S plus twice H2O. Now finally we have to check whether all the elements have been, you know, balanced or not. So now sulfur, number of sulfur are 3 on reactant side, in product side we have 3. Hydrogen we have on reactant side 4, product side also 4. Oxygen on reactant side we have 2 and product side also we have 2. That means our reaction is got balanced now. Okay. So this is the balanced chemical equation or reaction. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt? Yes, sir. Okay. So now I'm going to give you one more, you know, example, so that you have to, you know, balance now. Okay. So if you want to take a screenshot, you can take. Otherwise, this video is going to be, you know, placed on.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, beta.
Sir, Hemant is in a waiting room with him, sir. Can you please allow him in?
Okay. Wait. I don't know why I'm not getting, you know, notification for that. I have made setting also, but still when I'm, you know, screening full on my laptop, I'm not getting any kind of notification. Okay, don't worry, we'll solve this problem. So till here, any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, so now I'm going to give you one reaction, and this you have to balance this reaction. It is Ag. Ag means silver. Okay, when it reacts with hydrochloric acid HCl, it gives AgCl salt. AgCl salt and hydrogen gas is released, H2. Okay, so can you balance the reaction for me?
Done, sir.
Done?
Yes, sir.
What is the reaction? Balance reaction?
2Ag plus 2HCl. 2AgCl plus H2.
Okay, very fast. But you have to go through with the process also. It is twice of Ag plus twice HCl equals to twice AgCl plus hydrogen. Okay, so this is the balanced chemical equation. Okay, any doubt till here?
No, sir.
So you will be able to, you know, balance any, you know, chemical equation if you will come, it will come in your examination.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Give another equation.
Yes. So it's for your homework. Okay. So one reaction will be sodium hydroxide NaOH when it reacts with sulfuric acid H2SO4 gives product sodium sulfate. It is Na2SO4 plus water H2O. Okay, so it is homework for you. Okay, so by, you know, next lecture you have to balance this chemical equation. It is homework. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay. It is really, really very easy. Okay. So let me check how much time do we have. We have only 7 minutes left.
How, sir?
No, because we have Zoom session only for 40 minutes. Huh? That's why. So we are getting only 40 minutes. Probably by next month, we will use that another application, Air.
I think Manoj sir has not accepted that app.
Yes, sir.
I think that particular application needs to be more developed.
Yeah, it has been half lit, but it's more modified.
Yeah, it is not fully developed. But probably we had to, you know, that Zoom app, we had to, you know, get subscription from Zoom app. Zoom. So that, yes, yes. Okay, so I think we had to end the session and we will reconnect. Okay, so because we have only 6 minutes left and any topic will not going to complete in that particular time. So I'm going to disconnect, then we will reconnect again, okay, within a minute. Okay. Understood, everybody?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I want, yes, so I want you all within a minute, you have to rejoin again. Okay. So
okay.
How many of them? 11 of them. Okay.